This is the boy that broke my heart when I was 17.
She took our breakup pretty hard.
I cried for weeks and weeks.
We shared one awkward kiss and then
you ended it the next day.
And 8 years later we met for lunch.
And I gave him a chance to explain. And he said,
I'm gay. I'm gay, sis.
What a plot twist.
I'm gay, but you still wouldn't be my type if I were straight.
This woman is my mother, but she's more than just a mom. If you think her job is easy, well, she's here to prove you wrong.
I pushed two children out of me, and that shit really hurt. But I do lots of other things aside from giving birth. I put food on the table, I make our house a home. I work two jobs until I find the time to call your phone. But you never call me back.
She's a superhero. She's a superhero. My mom is incredible. And nobody knows. She's a superhero. This is my friend Derek Huff. You may have seen him on Dancing with the Stars.
But high school for me was pretty rough. I got bullied by this kid, Brad Everhart.
Brad put Derek's head in the toilet because he did ballet. But now that Derek's happy and successful, there's something that he wants to say.
Brad, I bet you wonder why the prom queen dumped you, the one who got away and broke your heart. Well, it turns out she was a dancer who liked boy dancers.
And you can catch them both on the TV in your mom's garage. This is the girl I babysit.
Hi, I'm Chelsea and I'm the shift.
Chelsea breaks a lot of rules, if I'm honest.
She won't tell my parents because I made her promise.
So we're up past her bedtime writing a song to talk about the things we don't tell her mom.
My bedtime's 9 p.m.
It is currently 2 a.m.
Sometimes I eat dessert before dinner.
We both know you don't eat dinner.
I text my boyfriend on my iPad.
I'm gonna pretend I didn't hear that.
I told her I was allowed to watch rated R movies.
Which wasn't true, and her parents might sue me.
I've seen boobies before.
Hey, I'm home.
Bet now.
So you all know Katy Perry for her amazing records, but I wanted to give some credit to the girl that wrote them with her.
Hi, my name is Bonnie McKee, and I write songs behind the scenes for some of your favorite celebrities. And you might know a couple from Katy Perry. Like, you make me feel like I'm living a teenage dream. The way you turn me on, California girls were unforgettable. Then you see Duke's bikinis on top. This is the part of me that you're never gonna ever take away from me. No.
Is that it?
No, there's a couple more, but
okay, like what?
Like, I got the eye of the tiger, a fighter, dancing through the fire. I am a champion, and you're gonna hear me roar.
This is my Barbie girl, best purchase in the world. She's even life-size. Oh my god, you're alive.
Someone please help me, she has Ted Bundy energy. She cut my hair and tried to rip off my head.
Come on, no! Since I was 10, I had such a crush on Jesse McCartney. I knew all of his songs. It's been my dream for him to serenade me. In my living room right now.
I don't want another pretty face. I don't want just anyone to fool. I don't want my love to go to waste. I want you and your beautiful soul. You're the one.
Did you just sniff me?
No! No!
This is my friend, her name is Lo. She's super smart, but nobody knows. She's tired of people calling her a dumb blonde, so we wrote a little song to prove them wrong.
I've won awards from the president for debating and political leadership. I also have a Vanderbilt degree, got a full ride for a high SAT. But everybody thinks that I'm ditzy. Nobody sees me for me.
So for those of you who've called blondes dumb before, you can pack your things and leave. There's the door.
There's the door, bitch.
So my boyfriend asked me to write a song defending people with red hair and freckles. He brought one of his friends along, and they're gonna help me sing it from their perspective. Chuck Norris is sick, Emma Stone is super hot, and you sound like a dick when you call us carrot tops. No, we're not all Irish, and we're not spawns of Satan. And guess who writes for Billie Eilish? Her ginger brother Phineas. Stop ginger hate, it's getting old. Gingers are great, and we absolutely have souls. I'll take you to the candy shop. I'll let you lick my lollipop.
Whoa, this isn't your candy shop. Stop licking all the lollipops. Keep going and I'll call the cops. My great-great-grandfather came to this country and sold 6 cows for this spot.
I am a lost boy from Neverland, usually hanging out with Peter Pan. What? I swear I'm not trying to steal your man. We can both hang out with Peter Pan.
No!
She's dead. So Katy Perry and I kissed in 2008. It was an amazing first date. Katie, I wouldn't call it a date. Okay, whatever you say.
Katie, seriously, you need to stop hitting me up.
Yeah, I know you're right. I'm sorry. It's just, don't give up on us. I kissed a girl and it meant something.
It's been 13 years, it meant nothing.
I fully agree.
Are we in love?
Are you kidding me?
You felt it too, don't deny it.
Okay, seriously, we have to stop.
This is Harry from Too Hot to Handle. He's famous for a few makeout scandals.
Did you watch the show?
No, but my mom does a lot. And don't tell my dad, but my mom thinks you're hot. And since it's Valentine's Day, it would make her life if maybe you could send her a little Valentine.
Like, right now?
Could you?
Okay. Roses are red. Would your husband be mad if you left him for me? And your daughter called me dad.
Huh?
I always loved hot moms.
What are you doing? Stop it.